since 1978. Their only away win, that was in Super League at St Helens, round one 2013, and what a win it was. 40 points to 4, it was Nathan Brown's first game as St Helens coach, having just left the Giants for the big job here at Rowntree Park. Well, the Giants know they have a big job on their hands this evening, and James Robey could well hold the key for St Helens. It's going to be the Saints who are going to get this game in play for us. The third week of the Super Eights, incredibly, St Helens are still seeking their first win in this second phase. Mark Percival kicks us off, and here we go. I wonder what the next 80 minutes has in store. Another shock, or will Saints get back on the horse? Can you call it a shock when Huddersfield are sitting behind them in fourth place in the table and are one of the most consistent teams over the past two seasons?
Yeah, but they've got to prove themselves. They've got to give themselves the confidence to know that if they can come here and beat the Saints on their own ground, they've every right to say that we are well and truly in there for a chance of making the grand final. And when you look at the two halfbacks, you know, we talk about Burns and Walsh, they've struggled this season. Their combination has not been absolutely spot on. Yet Brough and Ellis, they have combined this year, and they are the best halfback partnership I have seen in Super League.
Luke Robinson is the dummy half. They've reached the last tackle of this opening set of the Giants. The kick is right down the middle of the field and is picked up by Adam Swift. And Swift returns it with 20 metres of interest.
Well, Paul Anderson won't be happy with that, because the chase, the kick was good, the chase was poor.
First touch here for Tommy Makinson, back in the side after 10 weeks. Injured ankle against Salford here in June. And this is great for St Helens. It's not so good for Huddersfield. The Giants caught offside at the play the ball.
Well, they all got back to 10 and then just stepped out of the mark a little bit too early. Paul Anderson fully aware that they need to get off to a good start. They're slow burners, they always are, aren't they, the Huddersfield Giants? But can they get rid of that tag, Eddie, of being also around when it comes to the business end of the season?
So Roby will just tap the ball and give it to Kyle Amore on the restart after the opening penalty of the match. And he gets to within 21 metres of the line. Walsh then hands it inside to Alex Walmsley, and he drives it in. It takes three Huddersfield defenders to bring him down. Jack Hughes one of them, Luke Robinson was another. This now is Walsh. He gives it to Burns, and the pass then is a short one to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. He gets to within half a metre of the Huddersfield Giants line. Roby's looking at the options both ways. Back it comes to Burns. Here now is Walsh. He stabs the ball through, but it wasn't the best kick, and Ellis drops on it.
Yeah, good position by the scrum half. Anticipated the kick, and now we find that Saints, they've stepped forward a little bit. There's a kick through from Walsh. As I say, they've got a great passing game, both Burns and Walsh. But yet they need to produce something that is going to put a bit of fear in the opposition defence. That's what I think Saints have been lacking throughout the latter part of this season.
Penalty each way in the opening 3 minutes. Caught offside at the play of the ball. Maybe an indication that the players are very keen to get stuck in tonight.
Well, I'm not surprised with St Helens. I just spoke with some of their supporters before the game, and they said it's the worst performance they've ever seen. I said, what, ever? Well, they were quite an elderly supporter. They said, perhaps just after the Second World War, we went through a period where we didn't play too well, but there has been a response here. We've seen with some enthusiasm the swift run and the run by Percival as well, sorry, there, that set them up into a good position. But I think the challenge here now is to play that intensity for the first full 40.
Luke Robinson, a little scampering run from him, not the tidiest pass, was all along the ground, and Kieran Cunningham is watching anxiously on. He would be desperate for a response from his players tonight. Akuma Tai will take it forward now into the 20 metre zone for the Huddersfield Giants. Luke Robinson is waiting behind him at dummy half. Earl Crabtree wants to have a run, and he gives the ball to Crabtree, then takes the return. This is Ellis. It goes wide to Brough. He gets away from the first challenge from Percival. Makinson got in there quickly.
Good quick play the ball, though, by Danny Brough.
And Ellis slides the kick in towards the in-goal area, and it's just a little bit too long.
Well, the idea was good, and as I mentioned before the kickoff, is that Danny Brough, Jamie Ellis, they really have cemented a wonderful relationship. It was a big gamble as well by the St Helens centre, Mark Percival. He came out on the angle. They finally got to Danny Brough in the end, but he threw the dummy. Good job that the cover defence helped him out.
Well, one of the things Paul Anderson talked about to Bill Arthur before the game was we've got to believe to achieve, and I believe he'll have spent all weekend reinforcing the solid messages, showing the players good images of how they play well, what they do and what it looks like when they are in good form. But at some point in this game, it might not go their way. And how, it's how they'll respond and react to those periods that will determine the outcome. The back end of the sets for St. Helens haven't been the best, and we've already seen good, strong evidence of that.
Well, it's a turnover. You can see there it's a knock-on by the second row, Louis McCarthy's Scarsbrook.
I think he's claiming that he was tackled without the ball by Aaron Murphy.
Oh, I think you can see quite clearly. Well, maybe, Eddie.
Well, I think he's claiming that, but he's clearly knocked on before that. I think the referee's taken the first offence.
Yeah, you can see the fingertips have got there. Only just, and then he pulls him back.
So it's the turnover, because that all happened on the last tackle of that set. And Akumatai trying to battle his way forward for the Huddersfield Giants. There's Robinson now with the scamper from dummy half.
Yeah, and that's it. They need a little bit more of that as well throughout this game, the Giants. One way you can just confuse this Saints defence is if you play the ball very quickly. Oh, that's good play. Great tackle by Swift.
It was on Leroy Cudjoe, who plays the ball there to Scott Grix. He finds Ellis. Here now is Crabtree. Thompson to him quickly with help from Amor and Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. Still inside their own half though. Oh, and that looked forward from Luke Robinson. Just looked as though it drifted forward slightly. Here now is Jack Hughes. And Hughes, of course, off to Warrington next year on a 2-year deal. It's with Ellis now, and he'll hoist the kick high and right down the middle. Swift's put his hand up, and Swift pouches the ball safely and will try and run the ball back, and does pretty well.
And again, we see a high kick from the Giants and a very, very poor chase. There was no pressure applied to the winger. He took that so easy.
Richard Silverwood's keen, isn't he? He does mean business, Steve-O, you're right.
He means business tonight.
The last two kicks from Huddersfield have been poor. One's gone over the dead ball line, let all the pressure off. That was an easy catch, really, for a player who's possibly been Saints' best in recent weeks, Adam Swift. He's got them back over this, and the pressure's been too easily relieved as Luke Walsh now kicks this over the halfway line, and James Robey gets an attack in the opponent's half.
Only just inside the opponent's half, though. Robey does restart, and he finds Walsh. He runs straight into the back of Joe Greenwood. Had to get out of the way. Oh, and there's a mistake by Walmsley. Was that stripped? Was that stolen? He was trying to offload the ball. That was the verdict of the referee.
He did well, did Leroy Cudjoe? Yeah, you could see he was trying to offload. I don't know why
he's got that in his armoury, Alex Walmsley, because he's so tall, he goes over the top of defenders. He tries that first and then changes his mind, tries to bring it underneath. And the knock on, the mistake, and the possession is handed over to Huddersfield.
Ellis gets the ball away to Crabtree. He just neatly sidesteps the first tackler. Can't get away from the next two. Walmsley it was, and also Luke Thompson. Akumatai again, trying to use his strength and barge down the middle for the Giants. Robinson waits.
Well, they're pinpointing the hooker, James Robey, out there on that right-hand defence. So there's good work from Ellis. Nice offload to Brough.
And Brough gets the ball away. It's all over the shop, but it's picked up by young Jake Connor.
It's a last. I thought maybe a Saints player had touched it. Brough with a high one.
And is this going to be a better chase? Well, no, it's straight into the arms of Swift again. The chase is better. No chance on that occasion for Swift to make any metres downfield. Here now is Josh Jones for the Saints. 100th appearance for the club. Josh Jones, the man, of course, who's off to Rugby Union for a couple of years, at least to the Exeter Chiefs next year. Josh Jones. As Greenwood plays the ball to Adam Quinlan, he finds Walsh, and here comes Kyle Amor again up the middle. It's a solid defence from both sides.
Sorry, Eddie, talking of defence, you can see that Huddersfield starting with a sliding defence. Oh, that little power from O'Connor, and he's been picked out. It's no good having it. Anato, when the referee's already blown the whistle. No doubt about it. Made contact with the chin. Didn't like it either, did Mr. Scarsbrook? I just get the impression that both these sides realise the enormity of this game, this 80 minute. Saints struggling to get back onto the horse, Huddersfield trying to prove to themselves that they can make it to the grand final. It's a nervous situation for both outfits.
Yes, it is, and if I remember rightly, some scribes were saying earlier this year that St Helens would be possibilities to go through the season unbeaten. Well, I'm afraid that has certainly not come to fruition in 2015. You write them off at your peril, though, and Aymore to the line and a score!
Wonderful strength!
He's happy with that, Richard Silverwood. And that's the start that they wanted. Kyle Aymore with the first try of the match. Coming back to the side after missing last week, ending a 22-game playing sequence. Only his second try of the campaign.
This was a penalty. Connor swinging arm, really, on the second row of McCarthy's guard from. And this is just quite simple. He should have been stopped. They had three men, and then the fourth man came, but it was far too late. Good work by James Roby. Looked as though he was going on the left side, then tattled back onto the right, and the big fella did the rest. Well, it takes a lot of hard work in the gymnasium to put the upper body strength on there, and that certainly showed. That's the major reason why he knows he's got the vital four, surely, and that'll turn to six.
Well, he featured on Monday Night Football on Sky Sports when you might have just seen him at Anfield. Liverpool took on Bournemouth and he went along. When the Liverpool side were making a couple of subs, he was just two rows behind Brendan Rodgers. So he's enjoyed his football and he's certainly got off here straight between the goals. There's no doubt that that's the first score.
Not a Bournemouth fan, is he, Phil?
I would have thought a Liverpool fan, the way that he was happy with that result.
Fair enough. Luke Walsh then from banging front to add the extras to the Kyle Aymore try. And that really was academic. That was only going to be one result. The Saints are ahead by 6 points to nil.
And you're right, Steve, or Kylan Moore should have been stopped. There was enough Huddersfield players in attendance. But that try, for me, is more about the moving parts and everybody moving, making themselves available. James Roby controlling it at the base of the play of the ball. But that's the second time they put that play on. And Huddersfield's uncertainty of who was going to get it, who was going to be the recipient of the pass and who was going to split and break the line. They just thought too hard and should have tackled the guy who got the ball, Kyler Moore.
And the biggest problem for the Huddersfield coach, Paul Anderson, you'll be querying why the fullback Scott Grick tried to put on a heavy hit. There's a heck of a difference between the weight situation between the prop forward and the fullback. Why Grick didn't go down to snap at the ankles and then leave it for the big fellas to stop him. It was too late.
Percival again trying to make some progress forward for St Helens, who lead courtesy of the first try of the match by Kyle Aymore. 6-0. Wormsley gets the offload away in the tackle. Aymore this time dabs the ball down and that is picked up. It was enthusiastic from the Huddersfield Giants, Yukuma Tai. Now it's Ellis and they are turning the ball over inside their own half still, St Helens. Here is Griggs. They have man out wide, which is Jermaine McGilvery, but at the moment it is with Leroy Cudjoe. And Cudjoe gets up, plays the ball to Scott Griggs. Now Ellis into centre field to that man, Yukuma Tai again. And Tai drives St Helens back a few more metres towards their own line. Crabtree wanted the pass, it went instead to Danny Brough, and they're watching Danny Brough closely, three men around him.
Well, when Danny Brough goes out wide and then steps back on the inside, he should have someone coming on that second phase. And he'll probably want it again.
Oh, that was nearly Crabtree caught napping then, because Hubie somehow got the ball away in the tackle. Paul Anderson just a little shake of the head. He's slightly concerned with the way this attack is building. And Brough dabs the ball with the outside of the left boot. Oh, and there's a knock on there by St Helens. Yeah, knock on by Adam Quinlan.
Great work there by Danny Brough. Not only the little dribble through, but again, what the point I was making. Watch Danny Brough do the step. There's nobody there. He's left with no option but to put the little one through. But look how he grabs the ball carrying arm, and the fullback Quinlan comes up with the error.
Yes, he turned an ordinary kick, really, didn't he, Steve-O, into a very good kick by that challenge.
I was just going to say that, Eddie. I don't think Paul Anderson would be happy with the way that that set finished. He'd be looking for his halfbacks, two experienced halfbacks, Brough and Ellis, who were in good form, to have more composure in that final quarter of the pitch.
Here goes Ellis, who's under the sticks. Ellis is under the sticks for Huddersfield. Quick response from the Giants. And that was lovely stepping from Jamie Ellis from only 5-6 metres out. and Kieran Cunningham. Well, he's immediately on the walkie-talkie, getting the instructions down to the people on the sideline for him, but Jamie Ellis has come up with a very important try for the Giants here.
Well, this was a neat little kick there by Danny Brough, and he got the arm onto Quinlan. Then they put the scrum down, and boy, Kieran Cunningham will be so disappointed with this. That was not good play from the scrum base.
Luke Thompson, who gets stepped. You were talking earlier, Mike, about halfbacks who are going to run at players, and you highlighted the two who play for St. Helens. Ironically, it's Jamie Ellis who's shown a great example of doing that. I think he could be a fantastic player. I would question Jamie Ellis's fitness, and I'm fascinated in the last 10 minutes of the last 10 minutes of the second half whether he's able to play at the higher level. As John Wilkin looks on, I guess listening to a message from the coach and relaying it after this little conversion.
His last try, Jamie Ellis, the 8th of May at Salford, as Luke Walsh popped the ball over from in front of the sticks a few moments ago for Saints. Danny Brough has done exactly the same for the Giants, and we're level pegging here at Langtree Park.
Well, both teams a little bit weak in that final quarter. It's Kyler Moore who's left grabbing. He scored the first try for St. Helens. He's left grabbing at Jamie Ellis, and Kieran Cunningham will have talked about being strong near his try line and not giving away and handing over soft and easy tries, and that was certainly right up there.
Well, they haven't won in a month, the Saints. 24th of July here, 52-12 against Hull Kingston Rovers. It was their third win in a row, and that night it looked odds on that Saints would be going to Wembley, but they lost to Leeds in the semi-final. Hull Kingston Rovers beat Warrington. That's sport, and that is rugby league.
Yeah, it can be tough on even the top teams, and once it starts getting into the brain box, especially the St. Helens, say, well, don't tell me we're going to lose three on the trot and get out of the... I mean, who would have thought it, that they could not appear in the semi-finals, Eddie? But it's on the cards, the way that the Huddersfield Giants are playing. They're building in confidence. Good link from the fullback.
Yes, and they're running this ball wide with Cudjoe, but that's good defence from Walsh and Jones. And also in there pretty quickly was Greenwood. Gricks, short ball to McGilvray. Now then, he burst through the tackles last week against Catalan twice and scored
a problem.
Two magnificent tries.
Amor?
Yes, Amor's down.
I think they've clashed heads. I think it's a bit of friendly fire. Big Mossy Missoy, he's on the pitch early. And they clash heads. If you're going to clash heads with somebody, Mossy Missoy is not the one you want to clash heads with. Kyle Amor, cops one.
And you can also see that Mossy Missoy is not too 100% either. He was grimacing, and not surprising with this sort of contact. And then he gets an elbow from McGilvray just to add a little bit of extra pain. Well, it'll make it difficult to be able to see out of that left eye. I'm not so sure Mossy Missoy can see out of any of them.
They're supposed to leave the field here now with a head injury.
Well, there's two of them with head injuries, isn't there? Paul Anderson shaking the head. I think he knows just how painful that is as well, himself.
To be fair, Eddie, both Cunningham and Anderson, the two coaches, they will not be impressed with their defence.
Well, Huddersfield have got the best defence in the competition this year. 79 tries conceded now in 25 matches and 16 minutes.
Well, he didn't look at Eddie with the way that Amor trundled his way over. OK, take nothing away from his upper body strength, but it was poor defence. And to be fair, Luke Thompson, the loose forward from Saints, got caught out. Very rare you see a try scored from the scrum. But Ellis was good, step right, and Thompson got nowhere near him.
Quinlan goes down under the challenge from McGilvray. That's Roby who gives it to Swift. And Huddersfield Giants here are hell-bent on keeping St. Helens pegged back near their own line. And Luke Thompson looking to do something about that.
Yeah, it's
down he goes on tackle number three.
It's ferocious defence, Eddie, by the Giants. Oh, that's great stuff.
Oh,
he can do it, can he, Joe Wardle?
Great shot from Wardle. He saw the drop-off. He knew who was getting it. Good shoulder contact.
That's a good run there from Roby, and it's on the last, so Burns rather has to just hump the ball downfield It's a good kick, as it turns out, right on the goal line of Huddersfield, where Grix will try and run it away from. Good chase by the kicker as well, by Roby rather, and also by Luke Thompson. That will have encouraged the coach. It certainly encourages their supporters.
And it all came about by a lovely run from dummy half by James Roby.
Now all over the top of the man as he's trying to get a quick play of the ball, and Huddersfield get the penalty.
Now that is just silly, Eddie. That is just silly. They're putting a good kick, a good chase. The over-enthusiasm, over-exuberance, whatever you want to call it, and Luke Thompson and Mossy Masoa, that's too much, fellas.
I agree with you, Baz, because, you know, you've already done the tackle. There's no advantage.
Oh, Cutjoe's away. Cutjoe's through the first tackle. He's away from Quinlan. And he's trying to turn Roby inside out. And the reinforcements arrived in the shape of Travis Burns. Huddersfield want to get on with it quickly. Robinson with the pass to Brough. Brough then goes wide and finds Grix. Out of the defence comes Makinson. Here is Jake Connor again. Connor with a couple of fend-offs, gets the ball away to Brough once more. Brough then finds Crabtree. And Crabtree, can he get it away from Amor? No, he can't. Roby finishes him off.
Quicker play the ball. Roby was good. Kept him hold.
Ellis. Good tackle by Roby. Mossy Masoa all over the top of him as well. That must have taken the wind out of Ellis's sails. Here is Robinson finds Brough and Akumatai! There's no stopping Akumatai! Huddersfield Giants have turned a 6-0 deficit into a 10-6 advantage, and the kick to come from right next to the upright. And Akumatai, in his third season with the Giants, the former New Zealand warrior, this is probably the best campaign that he has had for Huddersfield Giants. And that is a great try.
And it all came about by the penalty given away way downfield. Luke Thompson trying to turn the man with the ball. It was a very simple pass from Brough, but it was sufficient to go very weak defence, I'm afraid. You could see there, they all got confused. You'll see Travis Burns hanging back. But there was no stopping this fella. It was just a simple, simple pass from Danny Brough.
6 weeks ago, Huddersfield Giants could not get in the lead against the Saints here. They kept coming back. They kept coming back. They levelled the scores on at least five occasions. And in the end, they were beaten by a Luke Walsh drop goal. But tonight, they've taken the lead. Something they didn't do here in the fixture last month. And Danny Brough here, this surely will be 12-6. Just about midway through this first half, and Huddersfield Giants have the lead.
Well, look at this run from Leroy Cudjoe. Straight from the tap, this is soft defence. Again, Kieran Cunningham, when he gets his players in at half-time, so he'll say we're better than that, we're stronger than that. And from a set player, set piece, a big man running hard, and you watch the defenders from St. Helens, they get up, they hold back, and it's LMS who unfortunately gets 3 metres forward, sits back in the armchair.
Eamon McManus, the St. Helens chairman, he was in the club programme today, and he has apologised to the club supporters for what they have seen in the recent weeks from this champion team. And Paul Wellens, of course, last year at the Magic weekend, he had his say. They've had a couple of vein-opening moments this year already. They're a very, very honest club, and they will be delighted with that mistake from Scott Grix.
Boy, they needed it as well. It is amazing. You score a try, you've lifted the confidence, and you just turn off. Just a little blockage in the brain box there by the fullback. He anticipated it far too late, and by the time he got there, he was confused. Fingertips all over the place.
But what a mistake, right from the kickoff, after you've just taken a 12-6 lead, and now they have to defend this line. Thompson, he goes down. Roby is waiting, and Roby looks for the runners. It's Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. Akumatai gets the ankles. Down he goes. And now there's another penalty, because Warble would not get off Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. They're not going to take the two. They're running this with Mossy Masoa. The referee blow the whistle.
Well, it's probably difficult for Mossy Masoa to hear anything with all that bandage.
Well, is it going to be same again? Is it going to Mossy Masoa once more? No, it's going to Kyle Amore instead, the other man with the bandage round the head. So this is a big set coming up for both sides here. Can Huddersfield hold them out? Can St. Helens score to level things up? It's with Burns, now it's with Walsh, a little dummy from Walsh, and they get to him in the shape of Ellis and Grix and Jack Hughes.
Oh,
and
he's hurt. Looks like the knee.
Burns pops the ball up. Mossy Massoy again will have a run. Can't get the ball away though.
Roby on his own, throw the dummy.
Roby finds Burns. Burns gets it wide to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook again. He goes down under the challenge from Danny Brough. Roby is waiting. Roby looks, dabs the ball to the in-goal area, and just too long. Ellis took a huge gamble then.
Did he ever? But he put the arms out. Watch this. Ellis just tried to make sure that no one could sneak in either side of him. You're right, Eddie. That was one big gamble.
Big tick in the box for the Huddersfield defence.
Yeah, it certainly is. Anderson will be happy. He won't be.
After 22 minutes, Eddie, the one side you think will probably be the reigning champions and have been at the top for several years will be the team playing as the Huddersfield Giants. The confidence is really impressive for me. The control, they've moved the ball around, they're prepared to offload it, take chances, take risks. They look like a side high on confidence and play particularly well here. We're going to get a great contest because their opponents
that's got to be
are
a
under
penalty.
Pressure.
Sorry, Phil, but that had to be a penalty.
It was. Kopjak was making the burst through. They got him the first time and then they held on and another man came in over the top as well.
Well, Amor had done the damage. Then you see, he just hangs on. Simple. Makes it easy for the likes of Richard Silverwood, the one man with the whistle.
Oh, this is a good penalty as well that Danny Brough has just put in because they will start this now. And it's the one, two, three. It's the fourth penalty. The penalty count is all square, but you see where they start this set from, deep in St. Helens territory.
And watch for Scott Grix. He's hanging around.
Akumatai again, and it's another penalty for offside. They didn't get back onto the line. Will they take the two? I think Danny Brough is pointing that they will.
Yeah, Danny was very quick. They can see there's a huge problem. How are they going to stop that? Obviously need stitches.
James. Stuart, you might just explain it. Seems to me St. Helens aren't too concerned about conceding penalties, particularly near to their own try line. They want to get off the line as quickly as they can, and they're prepared to just let the referee blow his whistle in the hope that that'll stop a try.
Well, I think there's a few teams that are actually been doing that, and I think it's probably why the referees are keener to get into it fairly early on. And I think teams taking 2 points will sort of put teams off doing that, especially in close games that they're getting at this time of the year.
Well, this for an 8-point lead, and Danny Brough makes no mistake about that. And Huddersfield are ahead here by 14 points to 6. We've had 24 and a half minutes. The Huddersfield fans are delighted. The Saints fans have got glum faces. Let's hear from Bill on the side.
Well, Eddie, just more on that point, really. There's only about 200 of those giant supporters who've travelled here for the game this evening, and they have been the ones making all the noise this evening. The Saints fans, I don't think I've ever known Langtry Park so full of anxiety. It really is just on the edge, just watching a side that is just not quite at the races tonight. The players are looking at each other. Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook typically is trying to galvanise his teammates, and they're just waiting for something to click for them, but there's no sign of it so far.
No, Huddersfield are playing really well, and this is Hubie for them. Craig Hubie has played in every game so far as Hubie. Wardle with a great pass out wide, and Connor will come back off the touchline.
Yeah, they're playing with a lot of confidence at the Giants, but there's a complete difference between the two sides. You look at Danny Brough and Jamie Ellis, they're asking questions. You can't say the same about Burns and Walsh. All they're doing is just passing it out wide.
Here is Brough, gets it away to Ellis, comes further wide here to Cudjo, and Cudjo steps through the would-be challenge of Walsh. Good job that the other two were there. Quick play the ball again, though. McGilvray, you don't want to let this fella get up ahead of steam.
So difficult to tackle as well. Upper body strength strong.
Roby stood his ground, and up it goes high. This is an old-fashioned up and under from Brough. Well claimed by Makinson. Very well claimed by Tommy Makinson.
And that's a good ploy as well that Kieran Cunningham utilises. You know, you look at Adam Quinlan, he's not all that tall. So therefore, he's going to be peppered with a high bomb, and we saw that from Brough. But good work from Makinson. He came in off the wing, made sure that his height proved the difference.
Mentioned Damon McManus's programme notes. He also gave a big welcome back to Tommy Makinson. Said that they have missed him, and boy, they have.
Well, at the moment, they need to fire a big gun, and Alex Worms has been sent back on the field to do that. At times, St. Helens have looked unstoppable. When Worms has carried it forward and put a big dent into the line, that's a misdirected pass again from Burns. They're trying to go around the Huddersfield Giants. It's the last tackle. What's Percival going to do?
Well, they might have got away with this. They have to a degree. But yeah, the kick finds McGilvray.
Poor indication of the control your side have got. Less than half an hour played, and you're trying to make up a magic of play and then hope that your centre can kick it. That's obviously not what they would plan to do, I don't imagine.
You're right, Phil. It appears as though they don't have a plan out there. They look totally confused. You can see that the opposition getting over the advantage line, playing the ball much quicker.
Craig Kopchak, the Welsh international, plays the ball, and here now comes Daniel Smith. He's been used as a substitute since he arrived on a four-year deal from Wakefield. Now it's Wardle. Wardle down that left-hand side. Connor, that's a great run from Jake Connor. They needed a good tackle from Burns, and it was. They've reached the fifth tackle, so here comes the last. Robinson wants it. He's calling for it. Now he's given it in to Ellis. And Ellis then will find Brough, and Brough will dab the kick through. And Hughes is after this, but it's beaten everybody.
Yeah, just a touch too strong, but the idea was quite superb. They're playing to a very, very good pattern.
Steve, I think it's an indication in terms of the leaders and the leadership of Huddersfield as you see some quality defence coming in. Luke Robinson, who has seven on his back, he's playing at hooker. Jamie Ellis and Danny Brough were all involved in that last tackle. They would have made a decision to either pass it on or kick it, and it's the right people taking the right options that has Huddersfield on top in this game, not only in the scoreboard, but in terms of the rhythm of the game as well.
Well, this guy is just about to play the ball, and he's got the penalty. Silly play by Kopchak, messing around there, but the one thing I've noticed this season, that when this guy comes on the field, Sibelio, they look a far better side. And it's a throw of the dice by Kieran Cunningham.
Well, he has to find something, doesn't he? And we saw his captain, John Wilkin, is on the sideline. He's got the earpiece in tonight. He's passing the information on from his coach. They've missed the skipper. He was in hospital yesterday before he spoke to us on Boots and All last night, just having some minor surgery on his broken thumb, and he's hoping, keeping his fingers crossed, to be back before too long. But he's not out there tonight, and Roby gets the ball away, and Wormsley will go down under the challenge. But they're inching towards that Huddersfield line now, are the champions. And it's with Roby who finds Burns, and Burns will find Quinlan. Quinlan to Percival, and Murphy does a job on Mark Percival with a bit of help from Wardle.
Quinlan did well there. Because Murphy was pulling at the ball-carrying arm.
Here is Joe Greenwood. That's a good tackle again by Ellis. Reached the last one. What's Walsh got here? A looping pass into the arms of Thompson. Thompson then gives it to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook, and that wasn't the best finish to another set of six. It's a turnover. It was a knock-on by Louis.
Wow, again, how disorganised Saints look. Luke Walsh is in at dummy half. He makes the pass from nine. Luke Thompson, the big man, ends up with the ball, not sure what to do with it, and LMS, he attempts the kick.
Looked a touch high from Greenwood, got away with it, but I'm with you, Baz. You could see there that Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook took his eye off the ball at the final minute. You could see Danny Brough.
It's not his job, Steve-O. It's not his job to kick the ball, is it? You're six and seven, you're decision makers. It's their job, that's their responsibility. And they are the players who Kieran Cunningham has been pointing his fingers at this week.
I just wonder what effect those words have. I asked John Wilkin that very fact last night on Boots and All. He said, we've always been an honest club and we've had a little bit of honesty in the dressing room this week.
And some people can take public criticism and some people can't. So I think it was a risky play when he chose to make those comments public rather than privately. So we'll see over the course of today and the rest of this season what effect that has. But Huddersfield in good control here at the moment. They've got to ride the luck here.
Well, Huddersfield, down now. Sorry, Phil, Huddersfield won't have a better chance. In 22 visits away at St. Helens, they've only won once. They won't have a better chance to get that second win. away at St Helens. Huddersfield look in full control after 30 minutes.
And there was a little side issue, of course, the last time that Huddersfield won here, and that was the fact that it was their old coach, Nathan Brown's first match in charge of St Helens in 2013. Of course, Nathan went home with the grand final win in the bag at the end of last season, Kieran's first season in charge. It's been pretty plain sailing until the past month. They've entered this match on the back of three defeats in a row. Walsh with a high kick. And who's coming for this? Whoa, Scott Gricks got in the way of the two or three of them got in the way of each other, and Gricks has knocked it on, and it's six to go here for the Saints with Josh Jones in control.
Not only that, Scott Gricks made a poor attempt at it. It finished up, he got a real rattling round his head.
This is Adam Swift now. And Roby finds Walsh. Walsh then gets the ball away. Warmsley trying to squirm his way to the line, but there are three purple jerseys there who bring him down.
We haven't seen Roby move yet.
Roby to Burns. Burns to Quinlan. Quinlan slides the kick in. Tommy Makinson. Oh! He waited and waited and waited, and it just bobbled over the sideline.
Deary me. He was always waiting for a 47 bus.
Wouldn't come down for him.
No.
And then when it did come down, it shot off.
He wouldn't stop. He had his arm out. The bus just kept going. Oh, what a golden opportunity. It was a beautiful little dribble through. That should have been four.
Well, he hasn't played for 10 weeks, and before that, he was a real master at things like that, scoring the corner, whether it was off a kick, off a run where he's trying to ground the ball with that one-handed technique that he has. He's a quality player. 13 tries he's scored so far this season. He doesn't look right to me. He's limping a little bit in his run, but it's a desperate stage of the season for St Helens.
Well, it looks like Aaron Murphy receiving treatment way back downfield. Yep, he's been strapped up.
Oh,
big error.
Michael Lawrence drops the ball.
Could be a turning point. For once, you can just get a feeling that the St Helens fans should have done better with that.
They're fairly quiet, the Saints fans, aren't they? I know they've not had much to shout about lately, but they're quiet. They are as anxious as the team.
Yeah, and you could see that it was more relief, the noise that came out of the home crowd. Now, Saints have got to start playing the ball a lot quicker. I mean, Huddersfield Giants, they're very, very clever in holding down. There you can see Lawrence over the top. They wait until the last seconds.
Steve, I honestly think they've got to calm themselves down and try and get rid of that anxiety somehow. Spend some time down here, build some pressure. Don't necessarily have to score.
That was more like Saints, quickly through the hands. Jones was tackled. It's Roby. And now Walsh. Ooh, was that forward to Savelio? No. Savelio picks himself up.
That's
Roby.
Much better.
Roby to Walsh. Walsh then gets the ball away to Burns, and he is grounded. Oh, and there's a penalty here because Huddersfield are offside on their own line. The pressure is mounting on the Huddersfield Giants. Brough is not pleased. All that defence and then a penalty as they were approaching the last tackle. So, Savelio will drive it in on the first. He's just shy of that line, but he's on his back. And here go the Saints supporters. They're getting their voice as Roby finds Warmsley, finds Burns, who finds Greenwood.
They've not utilised a dummy runner once so far of Saints. This is where you've got to use it.
Roby!
Great tackle.
So close. Lawrence did well. Greenwood gets the ball away to Thompson. Thompson then to Burns. Burns fires the pass. And here comes Percival on an arced run. So far, the defence is standing firm. They've had just about everything but the St Helens kitchen sink thrown at them here. Roby to Walsh. And Walsh goes down, tackle number five. Can Huddersfield get another tick in the box defensively here? Roby dabs the ball to the in-goal, and it's Jermaine McGilvray to the rescue. He just pumps the ball over the line.
I suppose if Huddersfield are ever serious about getting to the grand final and winning it, they'll have tough times where they defend their own line as they are right now. It's intense pressure from St Helens. They've seen off six players there, and they've got six more here to defend. Their organisation, the commitment, the positioning looks brilliant. It's hardly surprising that Saints can't break through it at the moment. Breaking play here while Jack Hughes just has some treatment from the physio on the field. But I'll be fascinated to see whether Huddersfield can maintain their focus here now. Because, do you know, for most of the year, St. Helens are the best team at getting close to the opponent's line and finding a way over it. But the Giants' defence has been up to every question that's been asked.
They'll start this set from the halfway line. Wormsley, the legs are pumping, he picks up the pace. Kopchak gets the tackle in. Roby waits. Here comes St. Helens again in the shape of Savelio. Cruz Leeming is there, Michael Lawrence is there, the two substitutes. Another push on him, another penalty.
Yeah. And as I mentioned before, once Savelio comes out of the field of play, they're a different side. He gets over the advantage line. He's turning, twisting, he's very difficult to put down.
They're upping the ante, are St. Helens in the closing 4 minutes of this first half. Roby again, here's Savelio, finds Wormsley! And Wormsley just held up short. Roby, looking right, looking left. Another penalty. The referee's going to have a word with somebody after all of this, surely.
Yeah, surely. Next one, he's got to go to the bin.
Four in a row for Saints. Wormsley! Oh, he almost stretched out and almost got there. Again, Roby's having a look both ways. And Roby gets the ball back to Walsh. Walsh then finds Burns. Burns with a short ball. Great tackle by Jake Connor on the big man, Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. Here's Roby again. Back he comes to Burns. Burns then to Walsh. Walsh attacking the line, trying to step inside Hughes. High shot by Hughes.
Someone's got to go. That's four on the trot.
Five now, Steve-O.
Five, is it?
Well, this is building pressure, and Huddersfield have been under enormous pressure. There's the team warning. Any more infringements, and somebody's going to the sin bin.
So this is Wormsley. Can St. Helens get over the line in the last 3 minutes of this first half? Roby is waiting. Roby gets the ball away, Savelio again. Again, this Huddersfield line somehow stands firm. Roby, back it comes to Walsh. Here now is Burns, and Burns is wrestled to the ground by Danny Brough. And they think he was looking for a penalty. There was Burns, not coming. Roby, Roby to Walsh, spreads it. Greenwood, great hit by Ellis, helped out by Hughes, couldn't get the ball away.
Brilliant defence. Surely they can't hold him out.
Oh, someone's in the bin here. Someone is in the bin. I don't know who he's picked out. I think it is Lawrence, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, Michael Lawrence is in the sin bin. The referee put them on the warning. That's six penalties in a row, I think. Six in a row. Team warning. 10 minutes in the bin. Two in this first half. Eight in the second. They're down to 12. Surely they can't hold out now.
Well, you would think not, but they've got to do something other than just one out.
Savelio takes them back to that Huddersfield line again. This is a big 2 minutes for the Giants.
Yeah, but they've got a change. They've got to get a link going.
Walsh, back it comes to Burns. Burns then finds Quinlan. He's clattered. Roby. Roby gets away. Roby gets away. Gets the ball away too. Finds Percival. And Percival, referee shouts held. The ball comes out, it's another penalty.
Oh, dear me. Well, Murphy's injured. He's limping back into the line.
Stuart, the team warning is nullified by the sin bin, is it?
Well, it's not nullified. The referee will probably give him another penalty and then put him on a team warning again. Now, the whole thing about the team warning is to try and get a change in behaviour. That's not happening. You might have to take it further.
I don't think it's a question of Paul Anderson's team being naughty boys, it's just desperation.
Well, it's pressure. It's pressure. They're finding themselves in a bad position and they're taking shortcuts, really, to try and get back in the game, if you like, or get back into competing.
Well, if they've any sense, Saints, they'll target Murphy on that left wing. He can hardly walk.
Roby. Roby! Since two in the playoffs win against Castleford last September. He's got two inside two games, James Roby, and all that pressure from seven straight penalties has finally paid off.
And again, it was a penalty. High shot. That's another penalty. And then we find him, the same. Come on, we've got to do that. And there you see from Silverwood, the pressure was on. And they've got to do it again, offside, on this occasion. Look at Lawrence, He's gone out. He just walked into no man's land, left no occlusion bet. Silverwood, see you later. Then another ball steal. 3-on-1. They tried to get away with it. There's no way in the world that the fullback Scott Greaves is going to do that. And the man that's done it ever so often for the Saints outfit, James Roby, just before the half-time, has pulled him back. Surely they'll go into the sheds only 2 points down.
Well, they will, providing Luke Walsh adds the extras, but that was a period of constant pressure by St Helens on that Huddersfield line. And you probably saw in the crowd behind the sticks the St Helens young supporter asking the referee to put Huddersfield on a team warning. He did. Then he blew another couple of penalties, and at the end of all that, the champions got over the line for a try, which has constant pressure by St Helens on that Huddersfield line. And you probably saw in the crowd behind the sticks the St Helens
Ladbrokes, proud sponsor of the Super League on Sky Sports.
Curves invite you in. Curves help you escape. Curves inspire you. And definitely dare you. And the new BMW 3 Series was made for every one of them. The ultimate driving machine.
Begin a voyage of discovery with this fascinating collector's item made with precision brass parts. Build a model solar system, including moving planets, astonishing detail and astronomical accuracy, with a magazine that takes you further still. Build a model solar system, issue 1, only 99p.
With the summer months comes the spectacular 50% off Wix kitchen unit sale. With quality features like soft close, curved corners, and smart solutions to maximize space. Personally designed so it's just right. This remarkable event sees the home improvers of Britain flocking to Wix. Wix, let's do it right. And now there's an extra 10% off sale prices. Hurry, it ends Monday the 31st of August.
Hey, you!
Yeah, you!
Why on earth do you need to sign a 2-year contract?
Giftgaff puts me in control.
When people leave their cart, put a dollop of whipped cream on the handlebar. Put some whipped cream all over your face.
Turn around. Wasn't me.
The brand new series of Impractical Jokers, only on Comedy Central.
Colin saved money at Money Supermarket, and now he feels epic. Colin, you are so Money Supermarket.
Imagine, she won't have to remember passwords or obsess about security. She'll log in with her smile. He'll have his very own personal assistant. And this guy won't just surf the web, he'll touch it, scribble on it, and share it. Because these kids will grow up with Windows 10. Get started today. Windows 10. A more human way to do.
Is everything all right?
I may have made a slight hiccup with the colouring.
Hey! New neighbours.
Hello, Barry.
All right. Love's young dreamer.
Bet she's older than me.
You reckon?
It's high time I started living a much healthier lifestyle.
Double scotch, was it?
Yes, please.
Sorry, I was starving. Hope you don't mind.
Mount Pleasant returns, coming soon exclusive to Sky One HD. And in case you missed any of Mount Pleasant, series 1 to 4 are available now with Sky box sets.
Ladbrokes, proud sponsor of the Super League on Sky Sports.
We got Formula One coming up for you tomorrow, 8:45 a.m. starts the Belgian Grand Prix on Sky Sports Formula One. Meanwhile, here at Langtree Park Stadium, round three of Super Eights. The Huddersfield Giants leading St. Helens by 14 points to 12. Two tries apiece at halftime, notably for the Huddersfield Giants. Michael Lawrence going into the sin bin just before halftime, just before James Roby scored that crucial St. Helens try. Well, it's certainly a much improved St. Helens side. Disappointing last week in their defeat here at Langtree Park Stadium to Hull FC. Got off to a great start here, an early Kyle Amore try. Are you seeing an improvement, John, that improvement that Kieran Cunningham demanded?
I am, but it's not the explosion back into life that I think St. Helens fans were expecting.
That might have been asking too much.
Yeah, and I think there are still issues there with those halfbacks. It's not looking fluid. They're relying an awful lot on the halves. As a peek in the dressing room as well at halftime, it was significant who followed Travis Burns there and Luke Walsh into that anteroom, and that's Cunningham and Joe Greenwood and Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. That's significant because they're the two big enforcers who sit either side, which can help them out in defence and also can provide a go-to man in attack.
Absolutely. Paul Anderson, he'll be pretty comfortable now, his side with that two-point lead. He knows though, games between these two sides usually are decided by small margins, 3 points and 1 point so far this season. Okay, let's get into the analysis of it. It was a Kyle Amore try. Remember, Alex Walmsley held up early in the game, his front row partner, Kyle Amore, eventually breaching the line.
Yeah, and it looked fairly straightforward, looked like some weak tackling at first, but it's important to know who was there and who was out of position, because there were some players out of position. Scott Grix has had to work very hard to get himself over from what he thought was a real threat, this short side the play before, to get himself back into any kind of position. Because there's that distance between the two of them, he hasn't had chance to talk to Earl Crabtree, will not have had chance to talk to Joe Wardle, who comes off unsighted. I want to draw your attention to these three Saints players, because these are the only three on this side of the field, and Adam Swift is already making a move over here. He'll end up well over this side of the field as part of the next play. So what happens as a consequence of that, when you look at both of these guys, middle defensive men, who are sitting now the wrong side of the ruck, they've got far too many men now facing up against not much attack. You've got Grix, the fullback, who has had to join the defensive line. It's the last place you want to be on goal line. You want to be organising in an ideal world, your forwards, and then you tracking in behind to pick up and mop up anything
else.
You
will have to start here. He just doesn't usually get run at. He can't disappear.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, yeah, in an ideal world, one of the two guys that we highlighted before would be sat in this space, and then Grix would be sat off behind here cleaning up. That's not the case, and he's left effectively one-on-one with Kyle Amore, who makes him pay. Hard, straight, honest, a little bit of footwork, a turn, and he's got the strength to get over for the first try.
Look, if there was a criticism, it would be that Scott Grace could do better in that tackle, but Craig Hubie, who's a very good defender, he had a pretty good shot at Kyle Amore. He'll look back at that and think he could have done, I'm sure, a little bit more to stop that. A misfiring Huddersfield Giants attack in the first 15 or so minutes. It was after this scrum that they got their try through Jamie Ellis, attacking straight and hard.
Yeah, we spoke about Jamie Ellis a couple of weeks ago, didn't we? Another an addition this year and a new live threat for opposition players to have a look at, other than Danny Brough in defence. And didn't he prove it? It's Thompson here who gets himself all wrong. His starting position is not bad, but he loses his hips way too early, opens up the inside of him. And then he's relying completely on Kyle Amore out of the left-hand side of the back row and Quinlan, who comes out of the loose forward position, to tidy up. I'll run this through a little slower for you, because it's Ellis who sees here. Thompson's lost his hips, straight through, and then Amore's not got the gas. It's a good step, by the way, to get through the attempted tackle of Quinlan. and that evened up the scoreline. They were good value for that as well, because I thought they were making much more of their opportunities than Saints were.
They did, and Huddersfield came strongly back into it then. Akumatai ran hard off a Danny Brough pass. You want to have a look at Danny Brough's involvement in the play?
Yeah, I mean, this is something that I'm definitely going to ask Danny about after the game, because I want you to have a look and focus here. I apologise for choosing this angle, because it isn't the best. But have a look at Danny Brough here. Have a look at what he's looking for. Have a look at the quick scan there before he gets the ball. And that'll become obvious when we switch the angle here. And I try and pick it up at the right point. So Danny Brough's now received the ball. This is Danny Brough. We were looking for a second ago in this direction at what Danny was looking at. And as I jog this on ever so slightly, you'll be able to see that Huddersfield have put two men just here on one defender. And that's Crabtree on the inside and Akumatai on the outside. That'll be exactly what Danny Brough would have been looking for. Players talked about it with Luke Dawn last week, isolating one defender, making sure they can make one defender make a decision, and then to hit the right ball. That's superb, and a great line to finish off from Akumatai.
Yeah, brilliant, absolutely. Just a reminder as well, John will be doing touchscreen post-game analysis with Danny Brough right up here, so make sure you stay tuned after the final whistle for that one. Okay, Phil Clark said in the commentary, if you want to get to the grand final, if you want to show you're a top team, you've got to be able to defend your goal line. It looked like the Huddersfield Giants were going to do that as the half-time siren came closer and closer, but they were doing it by conceding penalties. Six penalties conceded, referee had enough, Michael Lawrence goes into the sin bin, and that allowed James Robey to score. Was it just the lack of a man, or was there another flaw in their defence?
Well, I mean, I'm going to be critical. I think the referee reached for his whistle far too quickly and set himself a standard in that first half that led
to... There
were
six penalties.
When we got to this stage, I can understand, but the whistle was going far too easily. There was an incident over this side of the field where he called held, Percival still moving in the tackle. I thought that was harsh on Huddersfield. What I am going to pick out is some courageous defence, some heroic defence during that period. Jake Connor, have a look at him first. He's the first of two examples. Stops, checks, moves on, steps up, and he's able to pull down Lou McCarthy-Scarsbrook on the button. That's great. Here's your next one. Danny Brough's been doing an awful lot of this as well. You're going to see a meteorite shoot from the left-hand side of your screen and wrap up a player. That's committed defence. That's somebody who's he's got the confidence in his own ability to connect when he makes the tackle, and he's also got the ability to read what's going on. And I think that's because of he's a halfback. He knows what people are looking for and what shapes are being offered up. But ultimately, eventually, you throw enough at people, And it's going to crack. And it was the good quick play the ball. We talk about front rowers finding elbows and knees. That's what we're talking about. Gone through the tackle, underneath the tackle, elbows and knees. It's a very strong, dominant position to be able to generate a quick play the ball. And then who's the man you want behind a very quick play the ball? Coming into the base of the ruck now, James Robey. And you leave the rest to him, and that's an outstanding try. Great finish and a reward for persistence with that pressure.
OK, I think there might be a St Helens sting in this second half. Just to remember, a reminder, last time we featured these two teams here at Langtree Park Stadium, here on Sky Sports, it was a very late Luke Walsh drop goal that won it for the home side, St Helens. The importance of this game, a win for Saints, they'll leapfrog Wigan and go into second. A win for the Huddersfield Giants, they will push St Helens into fourth and leave the Saints looking over their shoulder. Plenty to play for, second half coming up shortly.
Ladbrokes, proud sponsor of the Super League on Sky Sports.
You travelled. Booked a hotel. All to witness that crushing defeat. Is there life after a loss like this? You booking bet there is. And man, it is funky. You got it booking right. Booking.com. Booking.yeah.
I first started using Knorr chicken stock cubes for seasoning. I'd mash them into a paste with olive oil and rub it in to lock in the flavours. Some say you can't buy taste. I disagree. Knorr chicken stock cubes. Try it for yourself.
This is not going to be easy, lads. You've got to fight. Put your neck on the line. There'll be big decisions to make. You must be first to score. The right decisions will make all the difference. Here's a great offer from Betfred.
Fred, passionate about rugby league. Keep it fun. Gamble responsibly.
The all-new Suzuki Vitara. It lives from 13,999.
Head and shoulders, instant freshness and unbeatable dandruff protection. So you're at the top of your game. Up to 100% flake-free. Head and shoulders, the UK's number one shampoo.
This is an iPhone. And it comes with something amazing. An app store with over 1.5 million incredible apps. That's over 1.5 million hand-picked or inspiring, just plain surprising. Who knew a phone could do that? Apps. If it's not an iPhone, it's not an iPhone.
32 Red is great, but we want to make it even better, so we brought in an experiential consultant.
I prefer Must of Wow.
Like Surprise Seahorse, it's unexpected.
That makes players day.
I feel an offer coming on.
Join tonight and get £10 free with no deposit required at the UK's best online casino. Online, on tablet or on your mobile. 32red.com, where you're the big deal.
Prepare yourself for the adventures of the world's greatest superheroes with the DC Comics graphic novel collection featuring Batman, Superman, and many more. With groundbreaking stories and the most iconic characters from 75 years of DC Comics, start your collection of hardback graphic novels. Batman, Hush Part 1, out now, only $2.99.
This is always a prime fixture on the Premier League calendar.
Tremendous goal from Robbie Fowler.
Here, right. How does he do it? Yeah. It flew in for Liverpool. The right man in the right place. Thierry Henry.
Arsenal v Liverpool. Part of a big weekend of football on Sky Sports.
WWE SummerSlam, live Sunday midnight, Sky Sports HD box office. To order Sky customers, press the green button now or see channel 491 for further details.
Ladbrokes, proud sponsor of the Super League on Sky Sports.
We are giving you the opportunity to see two additional live Super League matches via our digital platform. You can see Hull against Leeds and Widnes versus Hull KR on the Sky Sports website via our dedicated online channel, Sky Sports Extra. Simply head to www.skysports.com/extra and log in using your Sky ID and password. Or you can also watch both matches via the Sky Sports for iPad app. Log in and navigate to our dedicated Rugby League section.
Yes, six live matches on the Sky Sports platforms across this weekend. This is the first one of them. It's the Saints-Huddersfield match, the third game of the Super Eights. And St Helens, with that try right before the half-time siren, have put themselves back in the frame here.
Yeah, psychologically, it was a real bonus to them to see the man that's done it so often for this side. James Roby threw the little dummy, went from dummy half. Oh,
Wormsley, oh, it's got Quinlan and he fiddled and faddled, but he managed to hang on to it. A break it was from Wormsley, that.
It just seemed to overrun the big prop forward.
Here is Walsh, gets it wide to Jones. Jones gets it further out wide to Adam Swift. He's right on the touchline, and wisely, he just steps a couple of metres into the field of play. Takes tackle number four. Here is Walsh again. Wormsley, the man who started all this, takes it forward once more. They've reached the fifth, so here comes the last for the Saints. Roby to Walsh, will hoist the kick wide, looking for Tommy Makinson. Makinson against Murphy. Makinson just could not quite get it.
It looks as though it's going to be, he's going upstairs to find out this, surely.
He's just checking whether it's a goal line dropout off Murphy or whether the knock-on came off Tommy Makinson, Stu.
Yeah, he was fairly confident when he made the call. I think it's come off Murphy, onto his leg, and then goes dead. And he just gets his hand inside Tommy Makinson's here.
Has Tommy Makinson knocked the ball on, though?
I think so.
He may well have done, yeah, looking at that shot. I think it's hit his hand, so it's a 20-metre restart, you're right.
Yeah, the right hand of Makinson got there first. Well spotted there, Baz.
What a break from the big fella. They're a better side when he's on the pitch. Tavellio and Alex Worms, they run hard. And what a shame that pass wasn't on the button if you're a St. Helens fan.
Well, I was getting back to the point in regards to Saints, psychologically, if they had not got those vital 6 points that put them with only two at the half-time break.
And that was almost the perfect start for them. This is a 40-20 attempt, but it went slightly wrong, and it runs over the dead ball line. So let's get down to Bill for the half-time news.
Eddie, Saints camp mighty relieved when they got those points on the board right at the end of the first 40 minutes, and Kieran Cunningham looking to build on that, and the words ringing out in that Saints dressing room at halftime: composure, patience, calm down. There is so much anxiety in the Saints side, really on edge, knowing that they've got to prove a point here tonight, under pressure as far as a top four finish goes. So much on the line for them. The crowd not on their backs exactly, but willing them on and just putting more pressure on them, and they've got to handle all that. And the only way they'll do that is to keep composed and stick to their game plan and do what they do best, and they take advantage of the numerical supremacy, which they should have, but they haven't, and they've just lost. And Huddersfield coach Paul Anderson will be relieved to see that one find its way to touch. The focus really for his team is this 6 or 7 minutes left when they are a man down. That is really all they're focusing on. If they can get through that without suffering any more damage, they believe with a full complement on the pitch, they can go on and do the job.
Well, St. Helens have had a couple of chances at the start of this second half. The Walmsley run and then this from Turner, and he just found the ground and couldn't find Makinson.
Yeah, not the time to have a little bit of panic in the ranks. As I say, we've seen the good run from Walmsley. And Sibelio certainly have upped the tempo. They're lucky to get away with that. That squeezed it. They got him for offside.
Yeah, they weren't standing square.
Just a lack of concentration, you know, you feel that you've got your opposition. You could see there that Turner, he never got behind Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. No option but to give the penalty. Now the Giants, they just want to stay down there. I was a bit surprised when Danny Brough went on the second tackle. It was a good kick, it was too strong, went dead in goal.
This is Kopjak, plays the ball to Cruz Leeming, looks for the runners, it's Brough. Short ball to Wardle, Wardle's not tackled, Wardle, has he scored? Has Wardle scored? If he's kept hold of the ball, he has got this down, and it's a try on the field. Remember, the 12 men of Huddersfield, they're down because they have a man in the sin bin. And is this manna from heaven for the Huddersfield Giants at the start of this second half?
Well, the referee wants to see whether he's tackled. We know Joe Wardle goes to ground. He's not held by anybody there. The ball comes up off the floor, so that's okay. He can carry on playing now. Just leans forward and puts the ball down. That's a try.
The video referees, Ben Thaler, Warren Turley, they've had a good look at that. And I think we all know what this decision is going to be. And the try is given. 50 days to Old Trafford, said the sign before we saw the try notification. And is this the year that Huddersfield are going to mount a real charge and get to their first ever grand final?
And all because of a lack of understanding between the first and second marker. That was a great effort. Quinlan knocked him down, but no one could get there quick enough. That's a beautiful pass from Brough.
But the attacking play from the Giants is far better than the home side. The angles of run, the timing, the pace with which the ball's taken in. And Joe Wardle, who's been brilliant in defence along with Jake Connor at stopping tries, has shown that he can score them when they get to the other end.
It's the double pump from Danny Brough that just sells the dummy to the Saints defenders, who are nervous and apprehensive. We keep coming back to the theme that's running through this Saints side. They look very nervous. And Jamal Elise, he's got some messages, I'm sure, that will be about composure and calming down.
So, Danny Brough, he's kicked 3 from 3. He has now kicked 4 from 4. And the Huddersfield Giants have restored their 8-point advantage. Remember, they are down to 12 men for the next 5 minutes at least.
Yeah, beautiful delayed pass there by the standoff, Brough, and he did well to complete it there. You could see Sebelio coming very late. Just tried his damnedest to dislodge it. Not what Kieran Cunningham was wanting. Certainly is for the fans that came over the Pennines.
So, what a start to the second. We thought it was going to be a start to the second half that St Helens would have savoured. As it is, Huddersfield, well, they are now 8 points to the good. And only what they deserve, really.
Yeah, and it all comes about by two incidents. Remember, Jordan Turner threw the ball into touch. Then they couldn't get the first and second markers sorted out. Penalty, 40 metres downfield. The result, the Giants stretch again to an 8-point lead.
What a handful Jermaine McGilvray is to put on the ground. This is the most settled side in Super League, the most consistent and confident lineup that they've had for some time. Same 17 here tonight as last week. And, well, they've been formidable tonight. They could be formidable all the way through, maybe to Old Trafford, but here there is a problem for Jake Connor.
Yeah, he got smashed late in the tackle. Nothing wrong with it at all, but you can see the impact coming from Percival right over the shoulder blades.
It was lovely ball movement though, Steve-O, wasn't it? It came from the right edge all the way over to the left. Good, deep, hard-running players in the Huddersfield Giants shirts. Looks like he's had the wind knocked out of him. Percival, he come away from that tackle, shaking his hand.
And let's just remind you what we've got coming up. How about this tomorrow? Sky Sports 1 at 7:30. Again from the Super 8, it's Warrington against Wigan. Is it the last throw of the Warrington dice tomorrow? We shall see. And the qualifiers, Lee, who have got to beat Wakefield, and Wakefield, who have got to beat Lee. It is a massive match, Saturday at 3 on Sky Sports 1. Lee at the moment next to bottom of the qualifiers table. And following that on Sky Sports 5 at 5, the Catalan Dragons against the Castleford Tigers. And if Huddersfield hang on for the win here, Castleford, well, they really could put the cat amongst the pigeons in this race, not only for the top four, but also the top three.
Yeah, the Super 8s, the Middle 8s, it's a real smorgasbord in regards to Rugby League on Sky Sports. That's a good chase.
And as well as all of that, we have two more matches, of course, available on the website on Sky Sports Extra via the website, as I say, or the Sky Sports iPad app. And here they come. Leeds are at Hull tomorrow. You'll be able to see that on the website. And there is another one on Sunday as well. Widnes against Hull KR from the qualifiers. Widnes going great guns, as are Rovers in those qualifiers. And, of course, we see the Challenge Cup finalists in those two games a week before Wembley. I wonder what effect Wembley will have on the team selections from Brian McDermott and Chris Chester.
Good run there by Roby. They're getting over the advantage line.
Oh, good put out pass. Here is Percival. Percival has got Makinson. Makinson's in. Makinson crowns his comeback with a try in the corner. He's hurt himself in the process. Danny Brough's upset about something in the background, but Tommy Makinson, 14th try of the season, incredible return when you consider he's missed the last 10 matches with the ankle injury that he suffered here against Salford a couple of months ago. He's all right though, the thumbs up's gone upstairs to Kieran Cunningham, he's okay to carry on. That's an important try for Tommy Makinson, it's an important try for Saints.
Well, it was that man, James Roby, that's got him out of a real, real mess there. The run from dummy half. You could see that there were four Huddersfield defenders all right out of it. Danny Brough took a huge gamble, and he was caught. There was no way he was going to stop it. Makinson, he was always going to dive through. They thought there might have been a little bit of a wobble, but you could see four or five would-be defenders He was always struggling. Good finish.
A lot of people play centre in rugby league. In fact, every team has two of them. But few do it with the class that Mark Percival shows. Week in, week out, he's got brilliant footwork. He can change direction without slowing down. And he can throw a pass, which very few others can here, off the wrong side of his foot. That was a very awkward pass to try and throw to Makinson. And he did manage to find his winger that helped to get that try on the board.
And Philly has good balance as well. Let's not forget that ball hits the floor. And he's almost in overspeed. He has to slow himself down, compose himself and find that pass. And the brave and courageous Tommy Makinson, who isn't 100% fit, gets the ball down for Saints, his first try of the second half.
So Luke Walsh then, can he pull them back to within two again? Luke Walsh. And it just hits the post and comes out. The drop goal king against the Huddersfield Giants just doesn't quite make the mark there with the conversion.
Well, every fan in the stadium who wears the white and red V wants James Robey to get involved in this game as much as possible. And when he jumps out from dummy half, the Huddersfield defensive line, Michael Lawrenson coming back into the fray after his sin bin. The Huddersfield defensive line, they just hold. They're not sure where it's going to go. It was a messy pass from Luke Walsh in the end, but it gets Saints back in this game.
And Michael Lawrence straight back into the action, and he's off and out of the sin bin, so 13 against 13.
It's been a costly sin bin, though, Eddie. First Robey, and then we've just seen Makinson put the Saints well and truly back into this game. And what a start in the second half from this big fella, Walmsley.
Walsh just lays the pass off to Greenwood.
He's done a good job, hasn't he, Jack Hughes? Of keeping this big fella, Joe Greenwood, very, very quiet.
Jordan Turner, substitute for the first time in his Saints career last week, and he's coming off the bench again tonight. Savelio, he finds Walsh, who gives it to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook, and he smuggles the ball away to Adam Quinlan. And Burns will go down the middle before, well, he was tackled by Crabtree, but then not held. So play on, Greenwood going wide here with Josh Jones. Cudjoe's after him, and Cudjoe brings him down. There's Adam Swift. And Walsh will come this way again, looking for Tommy Makinson once more. Makinson palms the ball down, and it's Percival, flings the ball back. It was a risky pass, it was a no-nonsense pass. It was one that would either come off or go to Gavins, but my word, it came off and Travis Burns plonks the ball down and St. Helens have clawed their way back.
Well, it's a one occasion where they went into panic mode and they've got away with it. Beautiful kick by Luke Walsh. That is the one thing he really can do. And what about there, back on the inside? They can't believe it. He palms it down. High into the air. And Percival takes a huge gamble. And Burns was on hand to finish it off. Great kick from Walsh. Nice tap down by Makinson. And it was easy for Burns.
And in the aftermath of that try, you might have seen Danny Brough chirruping away in the ear of the referee, Richard Silverwood, and I can tell you that Danny Brough now is on a personal warning from the referee, so we might see another yellow card if there's any more shenanigans from the Huddersfield number six. But the St. Helens number six has come up with the try that has levelled the scores, and Luke Walsh, he hit the post just a few moments ago from almost this very spot. And can he get his sights back in again here? Big kick this. This to give St. Helens the lead for the first time since the 10th minute. Oh, it's just gone the wrong side of the post this time. So close. Level pegging. 10.5 for the second half gone.
Well, Luke Walsh misses that conversion, but it's the accuracy of this kick. It's batted back inside. It's a wonderful pass from Percival. But two players who've been under the most criticism this week have been Walsh and Travis Burns. And as the Saints go marching in, you can see the relief and joy on the faces, particularly of that man, Travis Burns.
Yes, and how ironic for Burns that the former club, Hulkingston Rovers, off to Wembley next week. And he is battling away to get St. Helens off and running for Kieran Cunningham in these Super 8s. Huddersfield held the lead for exactly half an hour.
Well, they're going to struggle, aren't they? Because towards the end of the first half, and for the last 11 minutes, St. Helens have had the vast majority of possession. Not only have they got the ball, but they're playing it quickly. And as Mike pointed out earlier, that's what James Robey loves. A quick play of the ball, he can roll forward. Another penalty. The possession is so one-sided, the Giants need to hang on at times.
Well, the Giants are falling for the five-card trick. And I'm afraid that they're losing their cool. They're having a few words to say, especially Danny Brough to the official. It will do them no good whatsoever. Start having a chat with the man with the whistle and you'll come off second best.
Look at that, 73% second half possession to St. Helens. That's why Huddersfield suddenly find themselves very much on the back foot. And Saints in possession again with Burns. Pops the ball up to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook. Lawrence is there, Leeming is there, Crabtree was there, Roby waits, and Roby gives the ball here to Jordan Turner. Turner then to Burns again, now to Walsh. Walsh a short ball, and it's Josh Jones once more, and he will go down under the attention of three of them. The referee shouting at the Huddersfield defenders to get off the grounded player, which they do. Walsh turns the ball back then. This is Greenwood, and Greenwood goes down tackle number four. And this is a good run from Roby. And Roby stabs the kick in! Oh, and Quinlan was so close. Adam Quinlan, the man who scored a hat-trick here against Huddersfield when he made his debut. But he's so close.
He's claiming, Eddie, that Scott Griggs gets a boot to this. And again, it's Roby. Hasn't he changed his game around? Quinlan thought that there was a boot. Let's see.
It's either Griggs or McGilvray. I think it is McGilvray. Yeah, I think he's got a case there, Stuart.
Well, I actually think it's more than a restart decision that. He's kicked the ball out of his hands. That should be a penalty.
Brilliant play by Brophy.
No, it isn't.
It's not brilliant play.
On the full.
It's on the full. They'll take the two. But it looked as though they caught Saints napping. He knows how important that is. Surely they've got to get those 2 points.
Well, the signs come out from the sideline to go for 2 points.
Got to explain that on that kick, the ball needs to bounce in the field of play. If it does, then Huddersfield get possession where that ball went out. It would have been an easy way of getting out of their own half, but the ball has to bounce in play and then go over the sideline. He knows it, and his teammates now know they're going to fall behind here.
And you know, Phil, there's only really two past masters of that, and masters in this day and age, and of course that's Kevin Sinfield who loves to do that. And it was a good idea by Danny Brough. He's lost the plot slightly, though. Sean Long, he knows how important these 2 points are.
Yes, I don't think they're going to win the match for St. Helens, but it gives them the comfort of the fact that they are in front again in this match. A lot of words being spoken about Luke Walsh. I mean, we must remember that until he was injured midway through last season, everybody was talking about this man as a possible man of steel.
Well, we look at Quinlan here, who's got the ball. He's just got to put it down. If that ball's kicked out of his hand, I think that should be a penalty try.
Well, did they say
that Walsh kicked
the arm rather than the ball? But I know what you're saying. Either way, they're not allowed to kick the hands or the arms or anything else.
No, you can't kick out at someone at the ball when somebody's in possession of the ball.
But was he in possession?
Yes.
Okay.
So there you go.
Either way, Saints have taken the lead.
But only just. It might have been six. As it is, it's only a 2-point advantage.
It's a bit like a tug-of-war competition at the moment. Huddersfield have slipped and fallen over. They can't get back on the feet here, and they're being pulled out of this contest. Because the sheer weight of possession, the speed, the control, St. Helens want to go on with this here now. They want to get to the other end of the field.
Do we think that's a justified penalty? I think that Huddersfield and the ref been calm there.
Yeah, so do I.
Well, I will say that Robinson was at the back of the tackle when the tackle was complete, and he's worked over the top of the man to the front, and that's why the referee's given the penalty. You've just got to clear the ruck.
It looked to me, and I think to my learned colleague here, that he just fell over the St. Helens player. Was it Greenwood?
Yeah.
Well, all I can say now is that St. Helens know how to control the game. And this fella, he'll add a lot of impetus, but not only that, he's very quick to play the ball for such a huge man. And that means that James Robey will become so dangerous again. Get up and play. They were very slow playing the ball in the first half, Saints.
Well, here is Travis Burns again. He changes the direction of the attack, gives it back to Andre Savelio, who does a 360-degree move. Oh, and he was so close, wasn't he? He was so close. Grick's gone underneath him, and Kopchak was there as well. Back he comes from Robey to Walsh. Walsh gets it to Percival forward. Forward pass called by the referee.
And he was in a good position as well as Richard Silverwood. Walsh knew there was an opportunity, there was an opening. Yeah. See with the way that the fingertip of the ball came out. And it's good to see that the referee is in such a good position as well. Now, these are tough times for the Giants. They really have to come up with something. Probably they were looking for Danny Brough, remember? He tried to get the ball back from the dropout. It was far too strong, but it's capable of 40-20, and boy, Huddersfield need one.
Remember, St. Helens coming into this match. And there's another mistake. Not the best pass. Not the best pass from Luke Robinson.
Lack of concentration.
That needed to be off the floor, Steve-O. And you're right, it is about Danny Brough and some of those decisions he makes, but it's about the small decisions as well. Jermaine McGilvery has a defensive line running towards him. He needs that off the floor, and Luke Robinson's a very experienced dummy halfback.
But the worst thing about it, Luke Robinson passed that ball without even looking as to where the man was in position. This blind pass, dearie me, this could cost them dearly.
It could do, because this is a golden opportunity again for St. Helens here with Louis McCarthy. Scarsbrook goes down on the 20-metre line. And Robey goes left and finds Turner, and further left the pass went from him. And this time Huddersfield muscle up in defence as they have to for the next four tackles at least. Turner. He got the ball away to Big Mossy Masoi.
Look how quick he wants to get on with the game.
Must have a banging headache as well. This is Walsh, now it's Burns. And this time Huddersfield hold Travis Burns out. Four tackles gone, this set of six. Robey off the deck, Turner, Walsh stabs the kick in, and it's just too long. McGilvray took the chance then, and it came up.
Yeah, he had it covered well. Good work by the winger McGilvray. It had to be as well. He wants to tap it, get away as quickly as possible.
Well, Steve, what I think that Kieran Cunningham has done in the last couple of minutes or so is he's put Jordan Turner, the number three, in your screen. He's put him in the middle, and he's given him a responsibility. Instead of lumping all the responsibility onto Walsh and Burns' shoulders in terms of the creativity, he's got Jordan Turner on there as well.
Good hands from Cudjoe, finds McGilvray. He gives it back to Leroy Cudjoe as well. Cudjoe will just hang on.
They're not out of it, the Giants. They just haven't had good field position. Lack of concentration, giving away silly penalties, especially near the end of the first half. Five on the trot, I think it was, or maybe even six.
Seven it was, Steve.
Seven, yeah.
This is Hubie to Crabtree. Short ball that the Saints supporters thought was forward. We've reached the fifth. Here comes the last. And Robinson finds Ellis, who finds Hughes. Oh, and the ball hits the deck. And the referee wipes the tackle count down, six to go. Ellis has it for Huddersfield. Ellis gives it then to Brough. Brough senses something, finds Jake Connor, and he is found by Makinson. Good defence from Tommy Makinson. But six to go here for the Huddersfield Giants as Brough finds Robinson now. Robinson drops the ball off to Michael Lawrence.
Big fella Crabtree on that second phase.
There is Brough, here is Crabtree, tackled by Robey and Greenwood, but they're inching their way closer, are the Huddersfield Giants. They sense that this could be their moment. As Robinson gives it again to Brough, and he finds Wardle, and that's great defence from Percival. Oh, but he got a hand on that, so it's another set of six. And this now is Lawrence. So they have six more from here.
There could have been a call for the Shepherd there. There's a crisscross. Robinson going on his own. Burns gets over the top.
And Brough is waiting now at dummy half. He fires the pass to Hubie. Hubie then to Griggs. Griggs gives it to Ellis. Ellis to Hughes, takes the return. And Kodjo to McGilvery! Such strength, but has he got this down?
Yes, he has, before he touches it.
Oh, the referee gives it without reference upstairs, so he is as confident as you, Steve-O. And Huddersfield take the lead again.
And that's going in my top five this week. This is a fantastic try against the current champions to pass the ball across the field. The confidence, you can see the heavy rain tumbling down here now. Handling conditions aren't easy, and yet they've transferred the ball from one side of the field to the other. There's a little quick runner in. There's the ball, back six more players. That was the first time it happened. It then happened again, and then we'll see here quickly how they transfer it from the left to the right. McGilvery eventually gets it. Little runner in with Hughes. Ellis, quick hands from Goodjob. And despite three defenders, Jermaine McGilvery confirmed just what a great winger he is at finishing the chances his teammates create. Here it is, coming round to it. Finally, he waits patiently behind them all, steps inside, pushes hard to the line, and makes sure there's no doubt in the ground.
10 tries for Jermaine McGilvery in his last 7 games. What a run of form he is in. 4 2-try displays in his last 5. 2 tries in both of the Super 8s. 19 for the season now. Huddersfield's top scorer, and he's just proved in that shot there, of plonking that ball down over the line, despite the attention of 3 players. Why? Tremendous.
And Eddie, we saw a very rare specimen there. It's called a run round. And when you do that, it confuses the defence. And it worked superbly. Can Brough add the extras?
He's way out on the touchline, and he has scraped the post. So it's 2 points now in Huddersfield's favour, 24-22, and we're in the final quarter.
Lovely hands from Huddersfield, and you have to admire the courage and bravery in this game. As Phil's already said, there's the runaround that Steve-O admired so much. As Phil has said, the rain has started to come down, and that makes that put down all the more impressive. A slippy ball, and the spectators of St Helens, they know, and I'm not an expert in body language, but I reckon I've seen more folded arms from spectators and fans tonight than a long time. In I've watched quite a few rugby league games in my time.
Well, they're anxious, and they know that their team have not been playing well lately. Remember, they had lost. There's another pair of arms folded. They had lost 3 in a row when they travelled to Huddersfield in April, and the 11-8 win that night was priceless. Consistency, though, as the rain falls here in St Helens, has been a problem for the champions. They did win 5 in a row in May and June. That was their best run of the year. And now here, they're conceding penalties to the Huddersfield Giants and taking the lid off all the pressure.
And they should know about it as well. Greenwood makes no real attempt. He got both arms underneath the ball carrier. And we've seen it so often. Huddersfield have given away so many penalties that way. He's got to keep a good eye on this, as Richard Silverwood. And the message, for some unknown reason, Eddie, has not got out to the players. And I know it's only slight, but 2 points in these conditions, boy, it's not going to be easy for Saints to come back.
The time is on their side, though. It's time, of course, for Huddersfield to score more points as well, as Wardle takes that ball forward. And Luke Robinson waits again at dummy half. He looks for the big men and decides to give it to Hubie. And down goes Hubie on tackle number 4. And Robinson tacks the line. He was looking for a penalty there.
Yeah, tried to pinch it, Eddie. He made contact, but the referee said play on.
Brough slides the kick in on the last. Oh, it's bouncing everywhere. And well done, Luke Walsh.
That's good play. He did well. He got his foot against the post, did Walsh. They didn't tackle him when he dropped onto it. They had every right not to allow him to move.
Now then, Huddersfield will throw everything at St Helens here as they try and work this ball away from their own line.
This is where concentration has to come into the Giants' defence. Get back to the official. Don't give away a silly penalty. Don't hang around with a ball carrier.
Greg Richards off the bench. Tackled by Robinson. They've reached the last. Have Saints, have they heard the call? But Walsh, I'm sure, has, and he puts the ball in looking for a 40-20. He's looking for a 40-20 here. He's looking for a 40-20. It just did not skim off the turf.
Well, that's amazing on slippery conditions. But the chase was good. That was wonderful by the same.
Percival,
yeah,
was.
Percival, wonderful. But it looked for all the world it was going to be a 40-20.
That's a great run from the winger Murphy.
Yeah, especially because he's not 100%. He got a heavy knock in the first half. They've applied the pressure on him as well. And again, I keep saying it, but remember, the official Richard Silverwood, he's not messing around. Oh, good step. Get away from the sideline. Ooh, dangerous pass.
They're playing dry weather football, aren't they? And Lawrence hangs on somehow. Now it's Crabtree.
Good position there for the last.
Yes, they've got into St Helens territory. And Brough's kick will go high into the rain. Quinlan's underneath it. It's a sensational kick, this. It's still not out of the way. And Quinlan...
What a kick.
They have a penalty, Huddersfield. They have a penalty for someone being shouldered off the ball in the chase.
Well, they'll take the two, surely. Or will they take the tap? Interesting. I would go for the two.
You really think a four-point advantage? This part of the field, you need to score to win the game. You're two ahead already, Mike.
I'd take it. That was a towering kick, wasn't it? All confusion.
I think he's tempted Danny Brough, but I think he's thought better of it.
I think Makinson has... I think he's a culprit. Oh, they've gone for the tap. Had they gone for the two.
And here they come with Lawrence. They're looking for the six. That will just edge them even further ahead. And here is another penalty. Hands in the play the ball. The penalty count now mounting against the Saints. Robinson, Crabtree. Well, he took that standing still, Earl Crabtree. Hands out! Robinson again. This time it's Brough, and he gives it to Hubie, who was on the run. Good defence by Greg Richards. Robinson again. Oh, he thought about pinching one himself. Richards and Greenwood standing firm.
Yeah, and Richard did well.
Ellis and Brough. Now, here is Gricks. Great tackle again by Percival. Brough. Here comes Wardle down the left-hand side. Good ball! Aaron Murphy! What a pass that was from Wardle! And it allowed Aaron Murphy to go over in the left-hand side, and Huddersfield take a six-point advantage. The decision not to kick for two was the correct one.
Yeah, it certainly worked out that way, but what a wonderful pass by Joe Wardle.
This is the penalty that's a little bit interesting, isn't it? When the kick goes up, the referee eventually says that a Huddersfield player is taken out.
Makinson
on Ellis, perhaps. Well, that's what the referee's awarded.
It was a definite shoulder charge away. I know that if you're going in the same direction, you can make contact with the shoulder. But I think it was quite clear that Percival certainly stopped the Huddersfield player from getting anywhere near the ball. Great pass from Wardle.
Wasn't it just?
Yeah, he took out, he utilised Jake Connor as the dummy runner. Connor came searing through. Watch Connor go through. He knows he's not going to get it. Murphy does. As I say, he's not 100% Murphy.
Well, he's forgotten about any knocks and bumps and bruises he's got right now.
Well, the main thing is in these wet conditions that he held on to the football.
Now then, this is a huge kick. And Brough has missed it. 6 points. And how long to go? 11 and a half minutes.
Well, it looked like Huddersfield on that last play had more numbers than St Helens. It was Mark Percival who came out of the line on that occasion. You see him at marker here. Now, he's not where he's supposed to be. Good recognition and a wonderful pass and a wonderful execution. Puts Huddersfield in the corner, and Joe Wardle proving he's not just about running good lines and tough defence. He's got a good pass on him. And those Huddersfield fans are delighted with that input.
Yes, and they are beginning to believe. And John Wells certainly believed in Jermaine McGilvray and Aaron Murphy in the pre-match show, because he picked out those two players as Huddersfield danger men, and they've both scored, and he will be with Danny Brough at the touchscreen during the after-game show, the second-half analysis on Sky Sports 1. Right here, full-time.
More importantly than the tries they've scored, Eddie, I think the runs from the wingers, both of them, to get the side away from their own try line have been very good, very impressive. It is, the Giants score wide again here, but...
Ooh, Jake Connor.
He's take it in.
He just held on. His heart was in his mouth then, young Jake.
Certainly was. He's had a fine game as well.
Crabtree. Can he break the tackle this time? No. And Robinson, on the last, gives it to Brough inevitably, and Brough... I think that was a one-point attempt.
It was. Swift is knocked on. Well, Danny Brough was disgusted with himself.
It's the worst
attempt, Eddie, of a one-point I've ever seen. Well, Adam Swift, I'm sure when he watches this again, he's still shaking his head because he had no pressure, nobody around him. Here's the drop goal attempt. That's the 40-metre line that you can see in the screen. And he has too much time, not enough focus and attention. It bounces off his legs and his hands, and that's possession to the Giants.
This is where they miss somebody like John Wilkin. I've looked at the body language. Not a single St. Helens player has spoken to one of his colleagues. They've all gone back with their heads down. They're depressed. They're still in this contest. A long time, 9 minutes in rugby league, but they obviously have to prevent the Giants from scoring in this next minute.
The amazing thing is, Phil, is that the winger, with no one near him, why don't you use your feet? It's so wet out there.
Oh, that's the game. That was the game for Huddersfield, and Aaron Murphy knows it.
He could have wrapped it up. Oh, dearie me. Connor, superb pass. There was nobody there. He knows it. He cannot believe it. Neither can Saints.
The rain from the heavens has come to rescue the Saints there. My word. And if he'd have held on to that, even if he hadn't got across the line, they could have worked it back into the middle. And who knows then whether Danny Brough would have gone for another one-point attempt. I think he probably would have done.
Oh, that was a try. No doubt about that, and he knew it. Now it's important that Huddersfield do not let it get to them. Remember, Saints, they are the masters at coming from behind and snatching a win. And they'll be quite happy, Eddie, with the draw.
Yes, you're probably right. They would be happy with the draw. You're absolutely spot on there. But they want to win if they can. Everybody wants to win in these Super 8s, and Saints are desperate for the win because they haven't registered a victory in the Super 8s yet. That goes high off the boot of Walsh, but it's too deep this time. He's let it bounce. That was wise, really. Normally, we'd be criticising him for that, but in these conditions, that's wise. No way through for Murphy.
And this is where the nerves start to just set in. And you can see there, Robinson has obviously had the message from his coach, Paul Anderson. I don't want any running with it. And there we see the fullback, and he's lost it.
His gricks.
I've just said he sent out the message, and obviously the message didn't get to the fullback. I cannot believe what he's just done.
Greenwood for St. Helens. Roby waits at dummy half, gives it to Walsh. Here is big Alex Walmsley, who started off this second half like a steam train up the middle. Now it's with Burns to Louis McCarthy Scarsbrook, and it takes four to bring him down, and down he goes. That's the Huddersfield line that they are defending. Roby eyeing it up, floats the pass to Burns. He pops it up to Walmsley again. And Walmsley, he tried to offload.
Oh, he said he's been knocked out.
No, he tried to offload that. And Kieran Cunningham shakes his head again. What a frustrating night. Now, will Griggs hang on this time? Yes, he will.
Well, they better.
And that's McGilvray who does that. Ooh, now then. And the referee, well, he held his patience then with the Saints defenders.
That's good work, though. Just take it up to a good position. They know they've got a very good kicker. Well, they've got two. Danny Brough, Jamie Ellis.
And here is Ellis. And there is Brough.
Outside. You're off,
and he just hammers it down the field in between Quinlan on one side and Tommy Makinson on the other.
And it's a good idea to keep it low. Let it skid off the very, very wet surface.
And Steve, it looked like a bit of a slap in terms of how he connected with the ball, Danny Brough. But I think that when he had it in his hand, he saw where Tommy Makinson was and
changed, almost changed where he was going to put it and decided we'll just put it into the space and defend this next set.
Remember, last time they were here, the Huddersfield Giants, they lost to a Luke Walsh drop goal. He's only scored four drop goals in his St Helens career as Luke Walsh, and each and every one of them have been scored by Luke Walsh. He broke their hearts here last time they were here, last month. I wonder whether he will break their hearts again if he gets the chance. There is Travis Burns, though.
They've got to get 6 points yet, Eddie.
Yes,
and
they have.
And then they can think about it.
Oh, big
good hit
by
from Burns.
Burns,
yeah, but it's this is up the jumper
time. Oh, he's hurt himself too, by the way, Burns. You think he's dislocated a finger in that. Here's Aaron Murphy. Here's Aaron Murphy. Couldn't get away from Jordan Turner.
Good run.
McGilvray.
That's good play.
He's like another forward, isn't he, Jermaine McGilvray?
He's had a great game tonight. That's going to be a penalty.
And it is. The referee shouted held and they wouldn't let him go, and then they pushed him away a third time.
Well, they're desperate to try to get possession.
Into the last 5 minutes. St Helens. Are they in danger of not making the semi-final series for the first time ever?
What a kick from Danny Bruff.
They have never missed out on the playoffs before.
Just look at all those penalties. I'd say a large proportion of them have been for the same thing, messing about at the play of the ball. And you're right, Steve-O. Jermaine McGilvray has had a good game, but he's had an outstanding season. And let's not forget, it's that try that he scored that just separates the two teams at the minute.
Well, Akumatai, they're camped underneath the Saints.
He lost
that. Oh, it's a knock-on.
He lost it. He lost it at the play of the ball. It just came out. Watch this. You've got to regain your feet before you put it down. And he's paid the price. Well, just when you wanted to slow things down.
Honestly, I was about to say, they're camped underneath the Saints post. What chance to go early for the 1 point and wrap this up?
Yep.
And Akumatai comes up with a knock-on.
Titan!
Blimey, who'd be a coach, eh?
It's a funny old game at times.
Well, I think there's three players you've got to worry about here now if you're a Huddersfield supporter. One's Alex Wormsley, because he's devastating. Two's James Robin. The third one I would be concerned is if Mark Percival can get his hands on the ball, because he's got magic feet and electrifying speed.
Well, it surprised me, Phil, that Scott Griggs is only 10 metres behind the defensive line, because surely they'll have the advantage to kick. He's dropping back slightly now, is Scott Griggs.
Here is Jordan Turner. That's four tackles gone. They're still inside their own half, St Helens. And we've almost got 4 minutes remaining in this match, and Greenwood couldn't get the pass away. Ellis got to him and did really well.
This will be a high kick. Will it go for Murphy again?
Well, there's Murphy on one side and there's Griggs on the other, and it's going straight up in the air at Aaron Murphy. And there's a collision off the ball, and Murphy has drugged it, and that's offside. Leroy Cudjoe is offside.
Well, we picked him out. I knew Murphy was going to be the target. It wasn't the best attempt, was it?
Time's off.
And as soon as he dropped on that ball, it was a high kick from Travis Burns. You can see it spinning all over. Very difficult to take, especially in these conditions.
Blimey, aren't these Super 8 something?
Well, there's a lot of drama, and you wouldn't want to be under one of those high kicks. Towering kick and the mistake. Will it result in Saints and points and get them back into this game?
Will it indeed? Short ball to Jordan Turner. And Huddersfield now will have to defend this line for their lives. And St Helens are going to have to try and get over the line, as they have done so often in their glorious past. That ball has come free. How's that ball come free? Roby has put the ball down.
It's a try, but has he lost it?
Well, it will be the second try. They've got no try on the field, he says, the referee. If it is turned upside down by Ben Thaler and Warren Turley, it will be Roby's second try of the match. And, Stuart, do we have yet more drama here, or is that the knock-on?
Oh, he's lost it as Wormsley. It's a knock-on, quite clearly.
Well, the call came originally about a ball steal, which is why I think Richard Silverwood played on to see if there's any advantage. But James Childers, such as, also said the tackle was complete. I think we've seen that the tackle's complete and he probably loses the ball after the tackle's complete. There's no ball steal there.
No.
The tackle's complete, the ball's lost. This will be no try and it'll be a scrum to Huddersfield.
And good play by Luke Robinson. It must be extremely tempting when you know with so many minutes remaining. This will be no try. Confirmation of that. But I've got to give a lot of credit to Luke Robinson for not attacking the ball or going anywhere near the ball.
Well, Super League's nearly men. They have flopped in the playoffs in the last two seasons. They have lost Challenge Cup finals, 2006, 2009. Can they turn things around in 2015? And the next 3 minutes will be absolutely vital, and that won't help Saints. Penalty, Luke Walsh, and Huddersfield will dump it upfield.
Well, he's just had a brain explosion. Well, you've done the tackle. Why on earth do you want to try to put him on his back? I just cannot believe that.
Look at the penalty timeline there.
Yeah.
There's been some penalties in this match.
We can hardly fit them on the screen.
Next line, guys!
We reckon there's 26 penalties in the game. Saints have had 14 and Huddersfield have had 12.
You were always good at maths.
No, I can see it on the tablet in front of me, Steve. I can read, and that's about all.
Good. Well, Huddersfield on three occasions now have come up with an error and allowed Saints back into it. This is one that you don't want to make an error. Just drive up the field. Go for the 1 point.
Well, they've had three tackles. There's Brough. Here now is Michael Lawrence. This is solid enough defence from St Helens. And Kopjak will take it forward. Wormsley cuts him down.
It's far out, Teddy. They may go for the touchline instead.
He has gone for the touchline. He's, ooh, I think it just managed to find the right spot on the field.
Boy, his heart must have been pounding.
Well, the referee's asked Ben Thaler and Warren Turley to have a look at this.
Oh, it's in. Oof. Oh, is it?
That's on the fall. He's hit the line on the fall, I think, that one. Yeah.
I don't think so.
That's where it hits the line, I think.
Don't you think it hits the line before? In the field of play? Boy, that's close. It's the apex of the ball that you've got to look at.
But he only has to touch part of the line. It doesn't have to be on it completely. I think there's enough there to show that it's touching the line.
Argument's academic. He said it's out on the full. He's brought them back. St Helens have got 1 minute and 15 seconds to rescue a point. That's all they are looking for now.
It's got to be a chip over the top.
Well, there's Griggs back on the right. There is Murphy slightly deeper on the left. Here is Walsh. Have we got drama in the last minute here at St Helens again? Percival could not get away from Brough. He's finished off by Connor. We're into the last minute now.
Huddersfield don't have a fullback. Griggs is about 10 metres behind his defensive line. So he's anticipating maybe the chip over. Will it come from Roby?
It's in centre field to Turner. Oh, and what are they making a mess of this?
Over.
Oh, St Helens, they're going to enter the fourth weekend of the Super 8s with no reward from three matches. Can you believe this?
You've got to believe it. Look at the scoreboard. This is up to jumper time, and the Giants, they've proved tonight that they live up to their name.
It's only their second win away from home against St Helens in Super League history. And Paul Anderson stated before the match, they've come here for the 2 points, they've come to win the game. They're 9 seconds away from that now. And Cudjo takes that tackle. He will be in no hurry to get to his feet. Here comes the final siren. A famous win for the Huddersfield Giants. And maybe a devastating defeat for the champion team of 2014. You can see what it means to Huddersfield.
Oh, it's a great win, Eddie.
And you can hear what it means to St Helens. They are shell-shocked. But they, the travelling fans from Huddersfield, absolutely delighted. Well, we talk about Warrington's season coming to an end last week. Is this the end of St Helens' bid for a top four finish? They're still in the top four, but the door is now wide open. Huddersfield are third, and Castleford can take them out of the top four if they win in Perpignan on Saturday. Drama all the way in these Super 8s. Brilliant.
Well, I think we see the best from the Saints when they're under the most...